hundreds of dollars, test scores and credit scores, measuring scholars, the suits in the schools and the grades and the jab. The American dream is a sleepwalking slob, safe and secure, leaving nothing to chance, afraid to touch girls at the junior high dance. He lived for approval, avoiding all trouble. They called him good boy, and he lived in a bubble, quiet and desperate for approval of those authority figures who hand out rewards. He got just enough and held on for his life, a split-level house, shiny stuff for his wife. And he sought out the warmth of his childhood bed, till the terror of unfamiliarity led him to jet at the glimmer of hope in his head. Then he got old, then he was dead. He put one foot right in front of the other, richly rewarded. He ignored the smothering blanket of his upper middle class life, the pot of gold after all his fear and strife, the festering part of his newfound existence, his knowing that he'd never offered resistance. Inertia had taken him just where it leads. He never once thought about worthwhile deeds, quiet and desperate for approval of those authority figures who hand out rewards. He got just enough and held on for his life, a split level hat, shiny stuff for his wife. And he sought out the warmth of his childhood bed, till the terror of unfamiliarity led him to jet at the glimmer of hope in his head. Then he got old, then he was dead. What should you want, and who is to say what's worthwhile, meaningful, manly, or gay? All's well and good, go and find what you find, but a sneaking suspicion, it haunted his mind. His existence grew fat, but he began to feel hollow. Had he missed his chance to do something but follow the footsteps laid out for him when he was young? When his children talked of heroes, he always felt stung, quiet and desperate for approval of those authority figures who hand out rewards. He got just enough and held on for his life, a split-level house, shiny stuff for his wife. And he sought out the warmth of his childhood bed, till the terror of unfamiliarity led him to jet at the glimmer of hope in his head. Then he got old, then he was dead. Went to the builder behind the tall cross, seeking counsel for some indescribable loss. Where he'd been taught that God smiles on his wealth, but the words of that book did not really tell the same story from which he'd drawn over the years. Seems like Jesus tells people what they want to hear. And he knelt and he prayed and felt fully alone, and he knew then by God that he'd have to atone for his greed and his lust in that split-level house, for the ignorance of how they hurt in the South, for fighting the right that he knew in his heart, sacrificing the good he could have tried to impart. Quiet and desperate for approval of those authority figures who hand out rewards. He got just enough and held on for his life, a split-level house, shiny stuff for his wife. And he sought out the warmth of his childhood bed, till the terror of unfamiliarity led him to jet at the glimmer of hope in his head. But then he got old, then he was dead.